paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime, and bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shouts and kicked in my face, but I've come through.
And I need to go
on, 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 on.
We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end.
We are the champions, we are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions of the world.
Well, it was the most intensely watched trial in world history. You had over 2,200 accredited media from around the world, which is more media than O.J. Simpson and Scott Peterson combined. And the verdicts were watched all over the planet when they came down. So it was a pretty intense environment. I had to focus myself on the courtroom, on the jury, judge, on the witnesses, and tune out most of what was happening around me. I think Michael Jackson is a wonderful person, sensitive, kind, generous, very artistic, very creative, and on a mission to do something for the world, which is more than I can say for a lot of people I've met.
Pennsylvania. Hello.
Hello, Larry.
Hi.
I'd like to ask Mr. Mesereau if there is a possibility that a malicious prosecution case be filed against the DA's office at Santa Barbara and Mr. Tom Snowden.
I think it would be warranted, but I have not discussed it with Michael Jackson. We just got the verdict, you know, recently. He's now recovering. Nobody has really discussed that issue.
But you think it was malicious?
I do. I think that he was treated in a way that no one else would have been similarly treated. It was because he was a mega celebrity. Why 70 sheriffs searching Neverland Ranch based upon what this accuser and his family said before they'd even investigated the background of the accuser and his family?
You're saying if he wanted to, he could bring a malicious prosecution suit and be successful?
Yeah. I'm not going to say right now what the merits or demerits of the suit would be. That would have to be explored. But do I think this was done maliciously and unfairly? Absolutely.
You had a tragedy happen to you during this trial. Your sister died of lung cancer, right?
That's correct.
How did that affect this whole thing for you? I mean, how did, emotionally?
Difficult emotionally. It happened right as the trial was beginning. Judge Melville gave me some time to handle the funeral and all the things related to that. It was very difficult. But I will say that one of her last messages to me was that she thought we were going to win. And I thought about her throughout the trial. Yes.
How old was she?
She was 53.
She smoked?
Yes, she did. She smoked from the time she was 13. And unfortunately, it took a toll.
Was Michael compassionate about that death?
Michael was not only compassionate, he sent her the most beautiful, the largest bouquet of flowers you've ever seen. He wrote a little poem for her. It came from he and his children, and it was one of the most meaningful, most wonderful things that he could have done for her during her final days.
How does he interact with his kids?
Beautiful. He loves his children. They love him. He spends a lot of time with them. He's a loving, doting, caring father. and his children just adore him.
Are they well-mannered?
Yes, they are. They're wonderful children. I was with them yesterday.
When you were doing your pre-trial questioning of Michael, when you have to get into a lot of subjects that are not everyday table conversation, was that hard? When you have to ask your own client, did you do this to this boy?
I'm not going to go into the questions I asked Michael. They're privileged and confidential.
Of course, but were they difficult for you?
Frankly, no, because the more I got to know Michael Jackson, and the more ridiculous I realized these charges were, and the more of a gentle, charitable, kind-hearted, decent person he is, the less difficulty there was. I mean, he always was a very straightforward, honest, down-to-earth person to deal with. And the Michael Jackson that I know doesn't even come close to the Michael Jackson they tried to portray.
And when you asked him,
he was an easy person to deal with.
And when you asked him questions, he answered you directly.
Of course he did. He's very honest and he's very down to earth. If you look at the few interviews he's done, you see a very, very simple, down to earth person who's very honest about who he is, honest about his loneliness, honest about his childhood. He's a very, very decent, kind person and easy to deal with.
And trusting.
Too trusting. That's been his downfall. He has trusted the wrong people. He has felt sorry for the wrong people. He has tried to heal the wrong people, and they've turned on him and tried to take advantage of him through the legal system.
Will he be tougher?
Yes, he will. We've already had a talk about that. He will, for sure. This was a horrible experience for him, and he's not going to allow people to just run wild through his home and because he feels sorry for them and wants to take care of them and wants to heal them. He has to get much firmer, and he will.
You said earlier you let him be him. You didn't tell him what to wear or anything. But the pajama incident, which got a lot of press, that bothered you.
Well, but that was not something anybody planned. He had to go to the hospital. He expected to be there for a short period of time. Judge Melville took a very firm position, which he had the right to do, and said get him here quickly or he was going to issue a bench warrant. So Michael had to run right from the hospital to the courthouse. He complied with Judge Melville's order. That was not something anybody planned or wanted. It just happened.
You think there was much to do about nothing?
I agree, absolutely.
You as someone who's close to him, at least. I've watched Michael Jackson for all these years, and I never felt like I understood who he really was. Give me a sense, was he anything like the person we would see on TV, or was there someone else that we never got to know? The Michael Jackson I knew was a gentle, quiet, sensitive soul. He liked to see people smile. He liked to see people do well. He had a very, very gentle kindness about him. He thought he could change the world with music, with art, and with kindness, and I believe he succeeded.
Well, I know he was a friend, so we offer our condolences to you, Tom Mesereau. We appreciate you getting up early this morning. Thanks so much.
Thank you for having me.